Hey guys, Mark DeRosa here. Welcome to the show.
And that'll bring in the Pittsburgh area native Ian Happ. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. The 1-1. And guys, you take a look at the White Sox entering play here tonight. All you can really say is they've been on one heck of a run.
Hey, thanks, Matty V. Hey, D-Row, we've got a couple of teams playing some good baseball right now. Unfortunately, a winning streak for one of these teams is going to end today, but boy, this is a great matchup here.
Yeah, I'm excited to call this one with you two guys, definitely. The two teams playing top of their game right now, really playing well. Both come in on winning streaks. We're going to see who's able to execute in this one.
Into his motion, here comes the 3-1.
Down
3-2 now. Very mild temperatures as we begin tonight. 58 degrees here at first pitch. Smoked on the ground up the middle. And this is going to scoot on through into center for a base hit leading off the inning.
I know in today's game everybody's trying to go yard, but can you look at having a better at bat? As a leadoff hitter, you take it full count, you make the pitcher work, and then you come through with a knock. Great start.
Anthony Rizzo stands in now, and he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. Happ gets his lead at first, nobody out. Turned on down the line, but this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. From the belt, kicks and deals. And a breaking ball runs in and gets him, and I doubt there is any intent behind that.
Yeah, it was a great battle there, and he was one strike away from putting him away. As a pitcher, you hate to put a guy on for free after all that work.
Here's the young catcher, Wilson Contreras. He's assuming the role of DH in this interleague matchup.
Yeah, Matt, that's one of the funny things about National League teams playing in AL ballparks. All of a sudden, the lineup kind of changes dramatically. But the cool thing is it gets more guys a chance to get some at-bats or time in the field.
A ball and two strikes. And set up behind the dish is Woody Keller, as you see the rest of our umpiring crew there.
You know, D-Ro, Woody Keller's a good umpire, but at times the consistency kind of wavers a little bit. I'm not sure if you'd say he's a low ball umpire or a high ball umpire. Sometimes his zone changes from game to game.
Yeah, he can be a little inconsistent, Dan, no question about it, but he's approachable. As an offensive player, I just want to be able to turn around and say, is that as far as you're going today? And Woody will usually give you an answer.
There's a swing, and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. Engel is there, and that should be deep enough to score the run. And the run will score as the Cubs strike first to lead it 1-0.
Well, this ends up being a sac fly, but you've got to love the effort out there. Sacrificed his body to make that catch, and I'll tell you, that didn't feel good. Probably saved extra bases by making that play.
So a runner at first here with two gone in the inning. And into bat next, the versatile weapon, Javier Baez. Set, here's the 3-1, and it's fouled away.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
And a good at-bat that time as he lays off for ball four. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away.
Well, that was a slider in a 3-2 count, and it just didn't tempt him enough to get a good swing. A good job of pitch recognition and knowing the strike zone to draw the free pass there.
So striding forward now, Kyle Schwarber. And a great chance here for the Cubbies to add on in just the first inning. 1-2, here it is. A swing and a miss as he chased with two strikes, and that will retire the side. Only one in the inning for the Cubs. We'll move on to the bottom half of inning number one. It's the Cubs 1 and the White Sox coming to bat. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. And that'll bring up the shortstop, Tim Anderson. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. And he looks at a cold strike 3 as the cut fastball's in there, and that's out number one.
Well, at the plate, he kind of got bailed out on that previous pitch. I think it should have been a strike. Then he goes down looking, and you really can't feel too sorry for him. Not a lot of protecting with two strikes there.
Into the box now, Yoan Moncada. And he popped him up over toward the left side of the infield. And there's out number two. Here's the catcher, Yasmani Grandal. No one aboard for him, and two gone here in the first. Bases are empty here with two men out. One is a cutter that misses 2-1. Well, guys, as we look at the Cubs coming into play here tonight, all you can really say is they've been on one heck of a run.
Matty, this is the best team in baseball right now. I mean, just a double-digit winning streak that, I mean, maybe happens to two or three teams a year you get this hot. This team is rocking in all facets right now, and they're a fun watch.
Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. 1-2-3 go the White Sox. They still trail 1-0. All set for the start of the inning, and now it'll be the catcher, Victor Caratini. That's lifted the other way out to left. Left fielder is on the move. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first out. Stepping into the box, Jason Kipnis, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Swing and a screamer, but this one's not going to stay fair. As anticipated, here's a ground ball now to the right side. And there are two away now. Into the box, Nico Hoerner. Not the shiniest of batting average as he comes in hitting down in the 220s for the year. The 1-2 misses ball two. Second inning here as the Cubs lead this one early 1-0. Won't commit on the slider. Good patience, and it's full 3-2. Ian Happ would be next. Into the corner and slicing foul. Another full count pitch home. Is offered at out of the zone and missed. And the throw to first will indeed get him. It's a strikeout, score at 2-3, and the inning is over. Nothing across here this half. We'll go to the bottom half of inning number two. Cubs lead it 1-0. Last half of the second set to go, and one of the more prolific RBI men in the league the last few years, Jose Abreu, will bat next. Now a swing and a fly ball, and it's a foul ball. The 1-2 is laid off for ball two. Still 2-2. Pitch on the way. Boy, good cutting action to that pitch as that's the first out of the inning. So the bases are empty with one man gone, and that'll bring up the power bat of Edwin Encarnacion. The 1-2. One out, nobody on. Still 1-2. Pitch on the way. Hit on the ground out to short. Baez has it. Throw on to first will take care of Encarnacion for the second out. In now the power hitting outfielder Nomar Mazara. As we take a look at the splits between April and May. Set. Here comes the 1-1. They'll run this one in on him and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
That front door slider is a devastating pitch. By the time you realize it's in the zone, it's too late and you can't even put a good swing on it.
And that one misses badly. It's ball two.
Playing two balls, two strikes.
And the cutter got him swinging. Strike three, and the side is retired. Down in order go the White Sox. They're down 1-0. So it's back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring up the former first-rounder and Pittsburgh area native Ian Happ. Here it comes. Sent in the air out to straightaway central. Robert is underneath this one. One gone. Digging in, Anthony Rizzo. Now the pitch. And he lays off again. Ball three. Bases are empty. One man out. Strike two as the fastball is let go. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. lifted the other way to left center. Engel is there, and he makes the catch for the out. So bases are empty here with two gone, and Wilson Contreras digs in at the plate. Two out, nobody on. Strike taken up in the zone.
Two ball, two strikes.
Back up the middle. Oh, and it eats him up a bit. And they'll have no play as he reaches first base safely.
Nice effort by the shortstop right there. Kept it in front of him. That's all he could do right there, Dan.
You know, Dealer, in a spot like that, that's an infield single. That's a tough play. Just to knock that ball down was a pretty good job. But any way you look at it, that should be scored a base hit, and I'm sure it was.
At the plate now, Jason Hayward lifted down the line and left. And this will wind up a foul ball.
You're lucky if you get one pitch a night right down the middle. Cannot be late on that fastball.
Yanked high and deep down the line and right. And it's a foul ball. The 2-2 pitch. A bouncer up the middle. Throw to second for the force out, and the side is retired. One left for the Cubs. They lead it 1-0. Digging in now, Luis Robert, and he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. Now the 2-1 pitch is strike two, swinging. Here now the 2-2. Right side hit hard. And the White Sox have their first hit of the game.
He's been cold. Batting average fell below 230, but that knock might have put him in a positive frame of mind. Hopefully that's the start of something big right now.
Striding into the box, Adam Engel. And he's carrying a batting average of just over 300. So clearly he's been a productive player with the bat in his hand so far. Now the 3-2 pitch. Misses. So a single and a walk, and it's first and second with nobody out.
Always tough to issue a free pass, but especially troublesome when you give up a single right before that to start the inning. We'll see if he can figure out a way to wiggle out of this.
Stepping up to the plate, Nick Madrigal, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. Swing and a soft liner. Foul. Good battle here. This will be the seventh pitch coming up. Fouled away. And he'll finally just wear him down as this one swung on and missed for the first out. Now batting, Tim Anderson, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Swing and a liner. And this is going to get down for extra bases, as that'll get one, if not both of them, home. And they're not going to get him. He's in there at the plate.
Just a great at-bat there. That one-out double gets a run across, and now they've got runners at second and third and are one solid swing away from making this a real big inning.
Standing in now, Yoan Moncada. High pop-up. Baez has a play. He's got it, and there are two down now.
Great scoring opportunity miss right there. You talk about frustration. Popping it up with two runners in scoring position, he'd like to get that one back.
And here's the switch hitting catcher Yasmani Grandal. 0 for 1 here in the early going. And he fouls this one off. And the 29th pitch of the inning is swung on and missed, and that'll finally end it. Some more of the colorful characters here at the ballpark tonight. We're back to Friday Night Baseball on the show after this. Start of the fourth upcoming, but first, Heidi Watney is standing by with a report.
Thanks, Matt. In between innings, I was able to catch up with the manager of the Cubs to discuss his thoughts on his lineup so far. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up, and he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
All right, Heidi, thank you. All set for the start of the fourth, and stepping up is the shortstop, Javier Baez. Two balls and a strike. Here it comes. Swing and a miss. Two and two now.
Hey, from a pitcher's standpoint, sometimes the greatest pitch is the slider that backs up. He got away with that one, but he wants that thing to bury down the way.
The 2-2. Doesn't get the zone. Count full now. Kyle Schwarber waits on deck. Ground ball right side. Throw to first in time. One gone here in the fourth. Good time now to check out the White Sox Road to the Show report, as you see a pair of guys in the upper levels that have been making waves as of late. In now, Kyle Schwarber. Changes up on him, but that's in the dirt for a ball.
Two ball, two strike.
And that is swung on and missed. He's down on strikes, and the first two are retired here to begin inning number four.
Boy, that's the best pitch in baseball right there with two strikes. That elevated fastball. Every hitter thinks that, hey, they can do something with that, but most of the time, you get the result that you saw right there. A big swing and a miss, and another strikeout.
Stepping in now, Victor Caratini. Lays off the fastball low, and it goes to two balls and a strike.
Well, we all know he's not the greatest threat with a bat up there. His numbers certainly aren't that pretty, but hey, I give him credit. He's really working the count right here.
Two and two to the Cubs catcher.
Hey, I'd like to see a little bit more discipline than that. You get a count in your favor, he's swinging a pitch that bad? Not good.
Now a fastball swung on and missed, and that is out number three. Cubs are down in order. We'll go to the bottom of the fourth, tied 1-1. Just about set to go for the last of the fourth. But before we do that, here's Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. I had a chance to talk with White Sox manager Rick Renteria between innings about his thoughts on his lineup's performance. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up, and he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
All right, Heidi, thank you. Standing in, Jose Abreu. He's 0 for 1 thus far. Right side. Rizzo is there. And the throw to first is in time. One gone. Edwin Encarnacion now. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. The 1-1.
Ball.
Hasn't seen a heater yet in this at bat. One might be coming right here.
Both teams with just two hits apiece thus far. Inside for a ball as he falls behind to him here, 3-1.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
The 3-1. And that misses for ball four.
Man, the pitcher's wondering how he didn't get that call. Busted him inside on a 3-1 count. The ump thought it was just a tad off the plate. Tough to get the benefit of the doubt from the umpire when you fall behind in a count like that, though.
So a runner at first with one man gone. And that brings up the versatile Nomar Mazara. And he can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1.
Call didn't go his way on 2-1, but it's important here on 3-1 to still make a quality pitch. You have to have the mindset that you're still the one in the driver's seat.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
Hey, he's got great feel for that pitch right there. He can throw it anytime he wants for a strike.
And he pops him up. Drifting toward the left side of the infield. Here's Baez to make the catch, and that becomes out number two. At the plate, Luis Robert. He singled and scored in his first appearance in this one. Darvish pauses. Here's the 1-1. No contact there, and it's 1-2. And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. White Sox leave one. Fifth inning coming up, tied at one. And as the second baseman, Jason Kipnis, comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ball game. Oh, that should have been ball four there, but it's a called strike, and that runs things full at 3-2. Really feels like he's just on cruise control out there on the mound right now.
Boy, this is a tight one. You kind of get the feeling like the next team that scores is going to win this one.
Now a changeup locks him up as he looks at strike three called, one away.
It looked like this at bat had the makings of a leadoff walk when it started 3-0. So that's a good job not to give in and battle back to earn the strikeout. That's not always easy to do.
At the plate, Nico Hoerner. And here's a ball hit in the air. And no one will track it down. The 1-2. Line to the right side. And that's into the outfield for a one-out base hit. Number nine batter comes through that time as it'll now be up to the top of the order with one away.
And that's a base hit right there on a hanging two-strike changeup.
And that's one we like to call a hanger right there. You see it high, you let it fly. Nice job by the offensive player.
Into the box, Ian Happ. Swung on and missed. One and two now.
He is in complete command out on the mound today. He's got all four corners locked in, and now he's raising eye levels to boot.
It skips in, and he's safe. Close play, but he's in there.
I like the aggressiveness with two strikes to put the runner in motion. Sometimes that can backfire, and it can turn into one of those strike him out, throw him out double plays, but he was able to get there safely at second.
Man at second here with two away, and into bat next, the left-handed hitting first baseman, Anthony Rizzo. Lays off the slider that time, 2-1. One run on three hits. No errors so far for the Cubbies. Grounder hit hard down the first baseline. But this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2.
He got the fastball where he wanted and just pulled off of it.
And another foul ball. The set and the 2-2 into right field. That's a base hit. He's in at second safely as they jump ahead with a run scoring on the play. So much of this game is situational hitting, guys. Nice job there.
Yeah, you've got to find a way to pick your teammates up when you're given the chance, and he doesn't try to do too much right here. He just takes what's there. Safely on second, and his buddy is high-fiving teammates in the dugout.
So now to the plate, Wilson Contreras. And that misses ball four, so it's first and second now with two out. Ready for another shot now, Jason Hayward. Two men are on with two men out. And here's a fastball, not close, as he runs it to 2-1 now.
Hey, time to start making some quality pitches. He finds himself in a tough spot behind an account with guys on base.
Counts even to Hayward, two balls and two strikes. Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch lifted the other way down the left field line. And this will wind up a foul ball. The 2-2 pitch. Well, the shortstop's got in play perfectly as he takes this in for the third out. The Cubs get a run courtesy of Anthony Rizzo. On to the bottom of the fifth. It's now 2-1 Chicago. Into the box now, Adam Engel, as we move past the halfway point in this one and begin the bottom of the fifth. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. This one's down to third. Fielded cleanly, and there's one away. So digging in now, Nick Madrigal. He was a strikeout victim in his first try.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind him, especially with runners in scoring position. Those punch outs will stick with you a little longer.
Hit out towards second. Kipnis is there, and he'll whip this one over to first, and he gets his man for the second out. So bases are empty here with two gone, and up next it'll be Tim Anderson. Darvish pauses. Here it is on 3-1. And this one misses high for ball four, and they have themselves a two-out base runner.
Well, you never want to issue a free pass if you can help it, But when a hitter like that digs in, you'd rather he's standing at first than driving a ball out of here and erasing your one-run lead.
So here's Yoan Moncada. Hit in the air down the left field line. And that will end up a foul ball. And a slider runs in as he has to lean out of the way. The 2-2. Slapped hard the opposite way, and he dives to make a spectacular catch. What a play there to end the inning. Worth a second look here, as this is a beauty to end the inning. We're back to Friday Night Baseball on the show after this. Cody Hoyer takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound. So stepping in, Javier Baez. He was a ground out victim last time up. Hit hard to third. Moncada fields it cleanly. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth. Now at the plate, Kyle Schwarber. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
Hoyer, a native of Montana, the treasure state as they call it, has a very strong chance of making the American League All-Star squad this year. He's currently the leading vote getter among relievers.
Hey, let's give a round of applause to the fans for voting this guy first at his position right now. He is not what comes to mind when you think All-Star, but you know what? Check the numbers right now in the first half. He has been a dominant player. This is well-deserved.
Got him! And he goes down on strikes for the third time.
Fooled him just enough with that pitch to get him to go around, according to the umpire. Sometimes it can be really tough for these big, strong guys because once they're committed to swinging, it's hard for them to slow their swings down, and that appeared to be the case there.
Low scoring game thus far, 2-1 here in the sixth. And he turns on this one and yanks it foul and back out of play. And they're working the outer half here, but that one's wide for ball three.
Pretty easy pitch to lay off there, 2-2. Not even close to being in the strike zone. He made it easy for the hitter in that one.
Pulled high in the air out to right field. Mazzara's under it. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. Three up, three down for the Cubs. They lead it 2-1. Bottom of the sixth inning now, and next to hit is the catcher, Yosmani Grandal. Three-two pitch. Pulled toward right center field. Half is to his left as he puts it away in the alley for the first out of the inning. To the plate now is the designated hitter, Jose Abreu. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. One out, nobody on. And that misses, 2-1.
2-1.
Down the third baseline, but this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. Looking to punch him out again, the pitch.
Full count.
Edwin Encarnacion will be next. One run, two hits, and no errors so far for the White Sox. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. Count still full, 3-2. Payoff pitch one more time. Donnie finally wears him down here as he strikes him out after a 9-pitch at bat.
Well, this lineup obviously doesn't get to see this guy very often because he's over in the other league, and it's really showing. He's pitching really well right now, and I'm sure these hitters are plenty happy they don't have to face him multiple times this year.
At the plate now, Edwin Encarnacion. Hot shot on the ground is short. And the off-balance throw gets him as he takes away a hit and the side is retired. Off of one leg, in the hole, falling away. That is pure magic. On to the back third tonight. Stick around on the show. Seventh inning ready to roll, and standing in now, the power hitting second baseman Jason Kipnis. Two and one.
Two ball, one strike.
Hangs on him a bit that time as it's belted out toward deep center field. Center fielder looking up at the track. The wall. Gone to lead off the inning. It's a solo homer here for Jason Kipnis. Fourth home run for him on the season. And with it, the Cubs have taken a 3-1 lead.
Well, this guy's been unhittable all year, but eventually you knew somebody would get to him. That's the first home run he's given up all year. But like all good relievers, he has to have a short memory and put it behind him.
Gio Gonzalez comes on now, and he'll take over with nobody out in inning number 7. Into the box now, Nico Hoerner. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Hit in the air down the right field line. Headed after it is Mazzara around first. He's digging for second. And now this will get over the wall down the line out there for a ground rule double.
Just a great approach at the plate right there. Takes that pitch on the outer half and goes with it. He clearly hit it well because it bounced right over the wall for a ground rule double.
Stepping in now, Ian Happ. Hit on the ground to third. Moncada has it. Throw to first is in time for the first down. Runner at second, one away, and that brings in Anthony Rizzo. The 1-2 is swung on and missed, strike three.
One of the big advantages to pitching ahead in a count if you're a pitcher, because you have to cover both pitches if you're a hitter. You have to cover the off speed and the fastball. And in a 1-2 count, you might be sitting off speed. And what happens? He gets the fastball and he can't catch up to the express.
At the plate, Wilson Contreras can't keep the weight back and he falls behind 1-2. Trying to keep the game close. Here's the pitch. Popped him up. Anderson is there. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. Cubs get a run here thanks to this solo home run. Bottom of the seventh inning coming up. Get up and stretch. It's now 3-1 Chicago. Last half of the seventh here, and standing in the outfielder, Nomar Mazara.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop and a blast. They could certainly use that right now.
Had nibbled the corner there, but missed 2-1. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Three balls and a strike to the Chicago leadoff hitter.
Hey, leading off an inning in this situation, three balls on you. You have to know that a solo shot's not tying this game up. You have to find a way to get on base any way possible.
And that misses ball four. It's a leadoff walk to start the home seventh.
Man, that's a tough one to swallow. You're hanging on to a slim lead, and the last thing you want to do is give up a leadoff walk. Seems like those are the ones that always come back to haunt you. So we'll see if that's the case here.
The Chicago manager up out of the dugout now, as he'll make the slow walk to the mound. And he's going to signal to the bullpen that'll be all for Yu Darvish. So as he departs, he'll remain responsible for the man left aboard, but he cannot lose this one. Adbert Alzolay takes the ball here as he'll enter with a runner at first and nobody out. Luis Robert will be the first to stand in against the new pitcher as he'll do so with a runner at first and nobody out. Count all the way full to the White Sox center fielder.
That was another good pitch and a tough call that could have gone either way. He couldn't get him to bite on it again, so the count's gone from 0-2 to 3-2.
Now the payoff pitch home, and he misses ball four. So he comes out of the bullpen and immediately walks the first man he faces. Riding in once again, Adam Engel. And he's looking to make something happen here with two on and nobody out.
Well, early in the count, expect him to look for a ball to drive. If he gets two strikes against him, he'll need to change his plan and focus on moving the runners up. This game is too close to get greedy.
We're in the seventh inning with a good finish brewing. 3-1 our score. Trying to give himself up here, but this is foul, so the runners will return. And this one's in the dirt. And a nice job to keep the runners at bay as the count moves to 2-2. From the belt, kicks and deals.
Down is full. Three balls, two strikes.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
Now the 3-2 pitch, fouled off. Payoff pitch one more time. And here's a fastball right down the middle of the plate that swung on and hit out to deep left field. And this one's not coming back. This is a long home run. A three-run shot down the line in left. Third home run for him on the year as they take the lead 4-3.
This is something. something you don't see every day. It had the distance the second it left the bat, but it was anybody's guess whether it was going to be fair or foul. That is, until it clinked off the top of the foul pole. No question or controversy now. That's an impressive homer.
Standing in now, Nick Madrigal. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Left fielder giving chase. Oh, and a great diving catch for the first down. Jason Adam takes the call from the pen as he'll try to get the final two outs of this seventh frame. And the next to bat will be Tim Anderson. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. Three runs already home here. Two and two.
Really deceptive changeup right there. It died right before the plate, and he was left reaching for air.
Still even at 2-2. Now here it comes. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Center fielder giving chase. He gets there, and that's the second out. Next to bat will be the Cuban import, Yoan Moncada. He was robbed of a hit in his last at-bat, so he'll try to change his fortunes here.
Yeah, you got to control the controllables, Matty. All you can do is put barrel to baseball and see what happens. You cannot control the defensive wizardry on the other side.
Two balls and a strike now. Now the 2-1 pitch is swung on and missed for strike number two. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
Now the payoff pitch home is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. Sox get three thanks to this three-run home run. We'll march on to the eighth. It's now 4-3 for the Southsiders. Jay Spry has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth. Ready to begin the eighth, and next it'll be the outfielder, Jason Hayward.
This thing's far from over, even though we're moving into the back end of this game. Only down by one. All they need to do is get this leadoff guy, and they're an extra base hit away from tying this thing up.
And it's fouled away. The 1-2 is a sinker in the dirt. Fry is among a dying breed, those lefty specialists whose roles are changing with the new rules around reliever usage. The 2-2.
Hey, this has been an epic at bat right here. I don't blame the pitcher for a little nibbling right there. Maybe get a swing and a miss. He didn't bite on that one, so now we go full count.
Neither guy willing to give in, and the at bat will continue. The next 3-2. Fouled away.
I know the fans love the souvenirs, but the battle between the pitcher and batter right here is what makes the game great.
And he finally puts him away here as he strikes him out after an 11-pitch at-bat.
Well, that call looked like it was a little in the pitcher's favor, but it wasn't outrageous. Hey, listen, calling balls and strikes is a really tough job, and even the best are going to miss some from time to time, especially when they're sort of borderline like that last one. Not sure the hitter would want to hear that, though.
Into the box, Javier Baez. And this one's going to bounce up to the plate. An easy take there, and it's 3-1 now.
Well, it's a pretty well-known fact that your batting average goes up as you get into more favorable hitters counts, and that's especially true when we're talking about this kind of hitter. Not a great spot to be in if you're the pitcher.
A bouncer to the left side. And there's out number two. So coming to the plate, Kyle Schwarber. Three at-bats for him in this one, all ending with him going down on strikes. The 1-1 home is swung on and missed, and that's strike two.
Hey, I can't have one of my best left-handed power bats fishing for balls off the plate.
And he'll strike out here yet again, as it's been a ballgame to forget thus far. Four strikeouts. Cubs are down in order. Score holds at 4-3. Bottom of inning number 8 set to go. And next, the dangerous power threat, Yasmani Grandal. Ready to deliver the 1-2.
No. Playing two. 2-2.
That was kind of a gift to the hitter. He's up there probably thinking of protecting on 2-2, but when you launch a ball that high out of the strike zone, it's obviously easy to take that one.
He's set. Here's the 3-2. He struck him out, the third time he's fanned in the game.
It's been a rough night at the yard for him. That's three times he's gone down on strikes in this one. So they've really figured out how to attack this guy.
So now to the plate, Jose Abreu. And they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1. And he fouls this one off. 4-3 our score here as we play the 8th. Takes this the other way to right. Into the slide, and he comes up with a great catch for the second out.
That's a slick play out there as we take a look at it on show motion. He was charging in quickly, and he slides to get under the ball just before it reaches the ground and gets the out. Well done.
Edwin Encarnacion to the plate now. And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Long run for the center fielder. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. 1-2-3 go the White Sox, and it remains a 4-3 game. Alex Colome takes the ball now in inning number 9, looking to close the door. Chris Bryant will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1.
And think about it. In game one of this series, they've already had to go deep into their bullpen. This could affect them for the rest of the weekend if they don't get really good starting pitching.
Three balls and a strike to the Chicago leadoff hitter.
Great situation right here. Leading off the inning, you gotta find a way to get on base any way possible. But I don't like to take the aggression away from hitters. If it's in your zone, I want you swinging.
Clearly off with his timing on that one, a swinging strike. Fouled off. Payoff pitch one more time. And a swing and a miss. Good pitch there for the first out here in the ninth.
When your closer comes in and strikes out the first guy he faces, everyone on the team can kind of take a deep breath. Still have two more outs to get, but retiring that leadoff guy is always huge when you're trying to shut a game down.
The 2-1 home. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two. The 2-2. Is a wave and a miss. He struck him out.
Well, you have to feel pretty confident about the way this one's going to end up as a manager. Two hitters, two strikeouts from the closer. There's not a whole lot more he can do to instill confidence that he's going to wrap this thing up without any problem.
Settling in now, Nico Hoerner. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here.
And he's got to build off that last AB. He battled. Usually when you battle, you get in that swing mode. A lot of pitches, you'll swing at the rock.
But this is taken in as a perfect metaphor to end this one, as that ball was hit hard, but the ball game is over.
Man, they've already put the all-time winning streak record in their rearview mirrors. But with every win, it gets further and further away. We could say this now. This is one of the greatest teams in the history of baseball.
And it's a 4-3 finish in this evening's ballgame. Chicago used a three-run seventh to help propel them to the win. Gio Gonzalez gets the win in relief, his second of the year. Alex Colome earns the save out of the bullpen, his 12th of the season. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter, @MLB The Show.